going to rotate around, and you're going to treat each of these test beds from another group as a station. You can start at your own, since you don't know what that one is anyway. And each station has a little post-it arrow pointing to one of our input devices. Okay? I'm going to ask you a few questions for you to discuss as a group, and then come up with a consensus and write that down. Does that make sense? So I'm going to give you a question, discuss it as a group, and then you say, okay, yeah, that's what I think too. Then you come to a consensus, so you come to an agreement. And then you're going to write down what you think that answer is, all right? So it's going to be in reference to whichever input device has got your little arrow. Okay, so starting with, so all of you have a different one, right? You all have a different input device. Alright, so the first question I want you to do is what is it? Now, you should know the name of it because when you're putting it together on the map, the name was given to you. But what is it? What is it? What does it really do? What is it? So, come to a consensus. Talk about it with the group. Don't write down until you come to a consensus.
So that would mean what kind of sensor is it? Zero and one. Digital, right?
I think somebody's getting his bag and getting it.
Okay, we have a consensus of what it is. Hey, the next question is how does it work? And then I want to see justification here. I want to see why do you think so? So you're going to say, tell me, how does it work? Why do you say so? So discuss it. How does that input device work?
Like a line inputs information, and then when it receives information from a line, it then outputs a motion.
This is a functional analysis.
It outputs a charge, but when it doesn't see anything, it doesn't output a charge.
You have to do a functional analysis by looking at something and trying to decide how it works.
There is nothing when there isn't something.
If you did a toothbrush and you decided, okay, well, like a toothbrush, you turn it on.
So the charge going in,
the battery, connects the circuit,
it stops when it doesn't see something, but it keeps going when it sees something. It sees the line.
Yeah.
Oh, well, this thing?
Yeah. How does it work?
Yeah, assuming you just give power and it spins it around in a drive.
Okay, so these are input devices, remember? So this is these devices. You're collecting it.
Oh, you bring it, and then it'll. Will it do about the same? How much is it?
What do you guys think? That's the trickiest one on here.
Oh, you mark different things?
Wait, yes, everyone has a different one.
What is this called on here?
Oh, it's a light sensor. So we put it together, like, through the hole at the top, and it converts to energy, puts it through these wires.
It's an encoder.
So how would it know if there's more or less light?
So
how does that sensor, I'm asking, how does that sensor work? How does it know? How is it going to tell the computer that there's this much light?
Does it reflect the light?
I'm not going to tell you.
Because that's any light.
Now, the final question for this particular station is, how could you use it? How could you use the information gathered from that input device in a practical way? So come up with a real use.
Basically. Basically just repeating the same exact thing over and over again.
What is it?
EDR.
Vex Cortex.
What is it?
It's basically... It's just, it inputs and outputs all this stuff. You put programming into it, which is say the
I'm honestly going to say the next one. Alright, next one. How does it work?
First spin.
What is it? It's green.
So,
collects energy and uses it to spin whatever is hooked up on top.
Your power,
it collects energy when you spin it.
Really?
I think so.
Electrical pushes out the energy and spins.
Yeah. No, these are all input devices.
Oh, yeah. True. Yeah, I would say.
So, I think
yeah.
It's like power spin it, and then, like,
that's what I'm going to call it. Power.
Honestly, yeah,
power
that makes sense.
Collector. Energy store. Oh my gosh, they're all power collectors.
What if you use it
that
to set, like,
this thing exists. Give me a reason.
Battery shortages and things like that. So, like, when all the power goes to one thing, it can, like, overload
it. Think
a
line sensor tracks that.
Not like. But, like.
Tech natural.
Okay. No, so, but, no, because it, volume control is one of the main uses, so, like, it divides voltage and everything, like, it separates it, and it makes it go different places, so it's not...
You could have a device with a line tracker on it, that...
It basically just controls, like, how much power goes to what thing. Like, if all of it went to this one, then it will...
Buildings that have, like, a lot of,
I don't know, rooms and things need, like, control where all the power goes, I don't know.
Is that... Makes
sense. I only heard the last part of that.
But maybe, yeah.
So, like, when, like, places have a lot of power and, like, they need it to go a lot of places,
like, because doesn't it, like, provide, like, voltage and stuff, like...
You're talking about for this one right here?
This thing, the, yeah.
What's that called, by the way? You know?
The potentiometer. I don't know how to say it.
Potentiometer.
We were pretty close.
Not bad.
I was in English. I didn't know what it was called. I just heard it before. I was like, the predicted number.
Go back one. How does that work? How does the thing work?
That's
yeah, you're giving me an example.
It's a sensor.
I just didn't hear how it works.
That
sensor. Oh. The motor, the battery powers it, and then that sensor right there.
What's going on inside there?
Little.
Minimum.
Stop.
Yeah, it
can motor? Right
inside.
So it won't start. But it didn't start.
I don't know.
It didn't start.
It doesn't give you a whole lot to look at, right?
No.
So you kind of have to make a guess what do you think's going on in there.
I think, like, there's some sort of a sensor that tracks, like, a difference in color, maybe. So, like, if you're tracking a line, it'll, like, see the color, like, on a piece of paper that it's different.
You don't, like,
it's not bad. What makes you say that? Why would you say that?
Well, I mean, it's called a line tracker, so I figured it'd have something to do with, like,
so
seeing the lines are, like, straight or whatever.
And they're soft.
And to do that, you need to be able to see the line, so it has to be able to sense a change in color.
How does a sensor see something?
When there's, like, a difference. It's chicken. Notice a difference. They literally sell
yeah, it does
chicken,
notice a difference.
Stuff, chicken sandwiches.
What is it? What is it? A difference in what, though, for... Your eyes, your eyes, you know, you know, your eyeballs work, and the light hits the sensors in the back, right? The nerves in the back, and it sparks them, right? So what happens with the...
So maybe, like, that mount's like...
Like that, see?